Hi everyone. So for this video, in order to get everything powered up, I need to make these C-shaped bus bars to connect the different batteries together. I'm using a thinner bus bar than last time because it seems like I miscalculated the previous stuff to be way bigger than it needs to be. So instead we're using this 1/8 inch stuff, which seems more appropriate given the rest of the system is 4-aught, based on like the ampacities I could find online. So to do that, Dad and I have made this bending jig where first it's bent around basically just this bolt. Dad's figured out how to add this die thing here to keep that bend tight. And then we screw on a block that sits above here so that it can then be bent around this bolt that we extend. And that way we can bend it past 90 degrees a little bit, let it back, and then put it on that one and bend the other end. Go ahead. And there we go. The other thing going today is this. The motor needs 1.25 quarts of Dexron 6, which has to be added through this little fill port in the side. And I need to do that before I can even really consider spinning it, so that's why the motor is out. I also need to install the low voltage wiring harness and get that run into the car so we can do all the control stuff to power it up. Alright, the motor's back in the car, and you can see here the low voltage connector has been hooked up. So it's got one line that runs along the back there to the motor encoder, and some others, not all the way routed yet, that run up front into the car through a slot that was cut there, big enough for the connector. And then from there, then the cables come up there, and for now they are just laying all over the floor. So next up, I gotta figure out what to do about all these cables. Hey everyone, so I'm getting the temporary switch panel wired up so I can do a drive test. So I've just put some toggle switches and stuff into this aluminum panel. So I've got one for the main contactor. This one turns on the pre-charger, which then charges up and activates the motor. Drive, neutral, reverse, as well as the signal to the motor that the brakes are pressed, since I don't have that right now, but it's going to be up on jack stands. So to put it in drive, I got to push the brakes, then hit the drive button. And then finally a switch that turns on power to the motor, the 12 volt power to the motor controller. I'm just going to hook it right onto the battery. I've got a little fuse there so it doesn't blow up. I'm also planning on hooking up the serial port here to my laptop, so that way I can just read it out and make sure that it's actually talking. I don't have the batteries all wired up yet, so for now I'm just going to hook this up as is and then see if I can read the serial port and see a, you know, no voltage alarm or whatever in the controller. All right, I flipped it on without the drive connected and sent it an A, and as expected, that causes the alert log thing to pop up. I don't really know what any of these alerts mean, but it is at least talking to me.
Right now, none of this is going to do anything because the controller is going to be unhappy without having the high voltage applied. Once I get the batteries wired up, all that I'll have to do is just flip this, and then that. This one doesn't make a click because the pre-charge circuit will not activate the relay unless it's detected that some current has passed through the pre-charge resistors, which it doesn't since the batteries are disconnected right now, so that's not going to do anything. The main contactor doesn't have any of that, it's just wired directly onto the switch. Hopefully you can hear that. So, tomorrow probably I'll wire up the final bus bars and we'll be able to see if the wheels spin.
Final connections have all been made. All that's left is to flip the switches and spin the motor. So Matt, if you could hold that.
Alright, here we go. There's that. Is that the main contactor?
That was just the manual disconnect. So now right. The main contactor.
And then what happens?
Now the pre-charge contactor.
I didn't hear anything.
Can you go watch the light that's on the pre-charge box?
Which is what, the little black one?
Yeah.
It's blinking red.
Stop blinking.
So, what's not hooked up?
Is it supposed to go green or something?
It's supposed to turn green, yeah.
Still red, but not blinking.
That's bad. Alright, so after a little bit of fiddling, I had to use a big power resistor to bring the resistance of the pre-charger down a bit because it wasn't pulling in. I guess there's a little bit of extra load in the motor or something. I'll have to call them and figure that out, but I've got it powered on. So we've got power on the motor now. So all that's left to do is switch on the drive. You hear that?
Oop, the wheels are turning.
Hell yeah.
Why are the wheels turning? Are you in creep mode on?
It's in creep mode.
Kidding. And guess what? It was even going forward, assuming you pushed the forward button.
I pushed the forward button, yeah. Alright, so that's neutral. Now reverse.
Oh, even creeps in reverse. Oh, I'm able to stop it with my foot.
Well, yeah.
Oh, is the other one spinning?
Yeah, the other one's spinning too. Alright. Neutral again. Damn, that's smooth. Alright, so I'm going to put it in forward. I'm going to gently pick up the gas pedal. And we're just going to...
That works.
Hell yeah. Alright, so that's all I'm gonna do since there's no load and they say it'll damage the differential if you mess with it too much, but that's the run.
Okay, so flip off.